This is just amazing. I actually didn't like the white wine last night.
Oh,
I did. Well, I'm glad you did. I didn't like it.
You probably are not going to like the reason I got to it.
Well.
Other than you have to drink it because it's the French wine. You have to have it.
I will enjoy it because you bought it for me.
I mean, it's a souvenir.
Yeah.
The church there had a big tomb. Yes. There was a window up there. She said there's a pyramid.
Yeah, I bet that Alsatian wine is better than the one last night. But just look at the... Oh, my God, dude, look at... Look at up here. Look at up here on this rock.
Mm-hmm.
But that is getting every... There are vineyards in there. Just among the rocks. That is just amazing.
Or at least they end up with it that way.
What are you saying? Eat that thing up that way.
I wonder if grapes on a slope sort of taste different than grapes on flat ground.
No. And he told us what things were factored in, and it had to do with the soil, the weather.
So to the effect that the slope affected the weather, it could affect it.
The slope doesn't affect the weather.
Well, I mean, it could affect the sun.
The soil. Period.
Okay.
He didn't say soil on slope, soil on flat. But, I'm sure that there's different soil on a flat terrain because of moisture and stuff like that.
Oh, yes, yes. Okay, that would be it. Yes, the slopes would have different soil. So it would affect it that way. Looks like there's some brand new ones up there.
Mm-hmm. So, for instance, if a different farmer could own that plot, these could all be different farms.
Yep.
So that's why you were saying different variations here. These are all different farmers. They very well could be. This is not like one giant. It may not necessarily be, is what I'm saying. Or at least that's where it was in the Alsatian. But we're still in the Alsatian. This is all Alsace.
There are people up there working.
Isn't Alsace considered all the way down to... I'm trying to think of my French. I mean, the German side changes, but the French side is still Alsace.
Wow. This is just amazing to see. Could affect the climate.
Ladies and gentlemen, on our right-hand side, we can see the town of Osterspy, which has 1,400 inhabitants. As we sail past, you'll be able to see the Baroque Church of St. Martin's and several old half-timbered houses. This is the town of Osterspy that we can see now on our right-hand side. Above the village, you might be able to spot a castle-like villa that was erected in 1873 on the spot of a former small Renaissance castle. This is known as Liebeneck, and you can see one of the towers. This is a castle-like villa that was built in 1873 above the town of Osterspy.
Vineyards are just unbelievable. They just are endless. I wonder how many. Did they? You might have told me already, but did he say like how many, like liters per acre, that anything produced?
Actually, he said it varied. Yeah, he did tell us that, you know, like a good year produced. I don't remember.
Well, that will be.
Yeah, he did say, but I don't recall. It was so many. Per acre.
Well, those will be questions I will be asking this afternoon. And if that varies between France and Germany, or different, or whether, you know, the Mosel region varies from.
I did see on another tour, you were with me. It wasn't that hard. But he showed us the hole. He said, you could crawl in that hole. Because we were all like, you crawl in that hole. And he said, yeah. outside there.
Oh.
And I had to scrub it down. He said, you actually have to wear a mask because you can get drunk on the fumes. So then the ladies at my table were saying, okay, really? I mean, your olfactory senses, you can get drunk on the fumes of alcohol? Is that true? I mean,
actually,
I've never heard of it. I mean, I didn't want to argue it with him. And I didn't know whether he was joking, like, this is a ha-ha. You know, because some senses of humor, I didn't want to say.
I'm not sure how it would enter your bloodstream that way.
You can't.
Yes, I don't think you could.
No. See, I don't want to. I've already had somebody make a comment about. I was taking notes. Some gal here, I'll point her out to you. I take pictures, and I've been taking notes, and you and I have just been talking about this one girl, and I'm sure she was just joking, she wasn't mean, but it's something I would never say to another guest on our show. She made some kind of comment about,
and maybe that's what
we were up on the sun deck, and you had walked away to tape something, or maybe go to the room, I don't know. She came past and she just looked at me and she said, you're on vacation. And I didn't know whether that was a question, so I said, oh, yes. She says, do you ever let your brain rest? Well, I didn't know whether that was a question, a comment, what was meant. So she was just standing there. And I said, and I had my guide out talking about where we were and what we were seeing. Oh, and she had been near when I was speaking French to one of our guides. So she says, practicing your French. You're following the map? You're studying everything? Are you here like on an educational trip or is this a vacation? I wanted to say, first of all, it's none of your fucking business. So I said, no, I'm on vacation. I said, but this is what I enjoy doing. She was walking away. She just was shaking her head. She said, well, some of us are here actually just to relax. And I said, but I'm retired. And this is what I do to relax. I caught myself. And I thought, oh, fuck you, lady. This is what I like to do on my vacation. I'm not bothering you about.
Yeah, you don't need to.
I don't know. And she's a heavy set lady. And I thought, what? Coming after me? Nevertheless, so I was on this tour. When people were asking about, the wood that was used, and normal types of questions, but I picked up on the fact that I saw stenciling and I saw this fish being used as a caricature on the barrels. So I asked the guy, and I said, what's with the fish?
Yeah, what's up with that fish?
That's what I said.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, a very impressive sight. We have the magnificent Marksburg Castle coming into view now on our right-hand side. So rising above the small town of Braubach, which you can see at the foot of Marksburg Castle, this is the only authentic, fully preserved medieval fortress on the Rhine. It is the seat of the Association for the Preservation of German Castles. It's been faithfully restored on the basis of architectural drawings from the year 1607, and has been furnished much as it must have been at that period, and really is a truly fascinating castle to visit. The ancient tower, the keep, is 130 feet high and really has a very commanding view. The circular part at the top of the tower is 26 feet high and was restored after it had been destroyed by artillery fire in 1945. The library has the world's largest collection of books on medieval castles. And you can note the way, like so many castles along the Rhine, that it sits on this rocky outcrop right at the top of this hill. The walls of the castle are in places simply continuations of the natural rock face. And this is what made such castles almost impregnable. Well, there is even a true to original replica of this castle in an amusement park in Japan. This was constructed after the German Castle Association refused to have the castle dismantled and reconstructed in Japan, even though they were offered an awful lot of money. Marksburg Tower is above this small town of Braubach, and it's really one of the most visited castles along the Rhine because of its very fine state of preservation. So you can see now, get your cameras ready, everybody, as we sail past this wonderful castle, Marksburg, that we'll be visiting this afternoon with our included excursion. For those of you who'd like to join us, we'll be driving back up the Rhine River. We'll be crossing over a bridge closed by Koblenz and then taking the right bank up towards Marksburg Castle, passing through the small town of Braubach. We'll leave the coach in the coach park, and then we'll have an uphill walk of about 10 minutes. We have four groups to visit the castle this afternoon, and we'll have official Castle Association guides who will take us on a tour of this magnificent structure. So this is the Marksburg Castle we can see now on our right-hand side.
Well, I mean, it's a really tough call. I mean, I
and you did make it to Germany.
I mean,
in a way, that's nice.
Well, I wouldn't mind doing another one. I wouldn't mind.
You could do the dog.
Yeah, or the road. Yeah, we can go upstairs now.
We'll be able to see one of the old towers of the city and also the part of the old medieval walls and some beautiful half-timbered houses as we make our way up to Marksburg.
I'm gonna I've seen his dad for a while. This is Rennes.
Ladies and gentlemen, here on our left-hand side, we have the town of Rennes. This town is famous for its mineral water. It has just about 3,000 inhabitants. But in the Middle Ages,